Welcome back for another example of solving a system of three equations with three unknowns using the method of elimination. To keep our work organized, let's start by labeling our three equations. We'll call this first equation, equation A, second equation, equation B, and the third equation, equation C. For the first step, we want to select two equations and eliminate one of the variables. It doesn't matter which two equations or which variable we eliminate, so let's go ahead and work with equation A and B and eliminate the z terms. To add the two equations together and eliminate the z terms, we want the z terms to be opposites. So if this is plus 3z, we want this to be minus 3z. So what we'll do is multiply equation A by negative 3 and then add it to equation B. So again, negative 3 times equation A plus equation B will eliminate the z terms, giving us an equation with just x and y. So negative 3 times equation A would be negative 3x plus 6y minus 3z equals negative 12. Equation B stays the same. And now we'll add the two equations together. Notice how because the z terms are opposites, this would sum to 0. So we have negative 1x or negative x plus 7y equals, this would be negative 6. So now we have one equation that contains just x and y. We'll use this again in just a moment. Now that we've selected two equations and eliminated z, we now want to select two other equations and eliminate z again. So if we look at the z terms in equation A and equation C, notice they already have opposite signs. So if this was plus 2z, we could add equations A and C to eliminate z. So for our next step, we're going to multiply equation A by 2. So we have 2 times equation A and add it to equation C. So 2 times equation A would be 2x minus 4y plus 2z equals 8. Equation C is just x plus 3y minus 2z equals 1. And now we'll add these equations together. Again, notice how the z terms are opposites. So this sum would be 0. So now we have 3x minus 1y, or minus y, equals 9. Now we've formed two equations with two unknowns. So we'll take these two equations, solve them as a system to find x and y, and then perform back substitution to find z. So we want to solve the system negative x plus 7y equals negative 6, and 3x minus y equals positive 9. And again, to keep things organized, let's call this equation D, and we'll call this equation E. So let's solve this by eliminating the y terms. Notice how they're already opposite signs, so if this was minus 7y, we could add the equations together to eliminate the y terms. So for the next step, we'll multiply equation E by 7 and add it to equation D. So 7 times equation E would be 21x minus 7y equals 63. We'll leave equation D the same, negative x plus 7y equals negative 6. Notice how the y terms are opposites. This sums to 0. So we have 20x equals 57. Divide both sides by 20. And so x is equal to 57 twentieths. This tells us that we do have one solution, but the solution is going to consist of an x, y, and z value. So now that we know that x is equal to 57 twentieths, we can go back and find the value of y as well as the value of z. If we take a look at equation E, notice how it only contains x and y, and since now we know the value of x, we can find y. So using equation E, notice if we solved equation E for y, we would add y to both sides and subtract 9 on both sides. So we would have y equals 3x minus 9. Now we'll substitute 57 twentieths for x to find y. I'm going to write 3 as 3 over 1 times 57 over 20. minus 9 over 1. And notice how to subtract here, we'd have to have a common denominator. So we'd have to multiply 9 over 1 times 20 over 20. So we have y equals 3 times 57 is equal to 171. Minus, this would be 180 over 20. So we have y equals, this would be negative 9/20. Now we have the value of x and the value of y, so we'll go back to one of the original equations to find the value of z. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. Let's go ahead and use equation A to find z. Notice if we solve this equation for z, we would subtract x on both sides as well as add 2y, so we'd have z equals 4 minus x plus 2y. So we'll have z equals 4, I'll write this as 4 over 1, minus x, which is 57/20, plus 2 times y, which I'll write as 2 over 1, times negative 9 over 20. And notice the common denominator again would be 20, so we'll go ahead and multiply this by 20 over 20. So we have z equals, this would be 80/20, minus 57/20, and this would be plus negative 18/20. Well, 80 minus 57 plus negative 18 is equal to positive 5, so we have 5/20, which simplifies nicely to 1/4. So z is equal to 1/4. So this is the solution to our system. We have one solution, so we can call this a consistent and independent system. Often the solution is given as an ordered triple, because if we graph each equation, it would be a plane in space, and the solution represents the point of intersection of the three planes. So the x-coordinate would be 57/20, the y-coordinate would be negative 9/20, and the z-coordinate would be 1/4. Let's finish by looking at the graph of these three planes in space and see if we can find this point of intersection. Here's the graph of the three planes. Notice this point here is the only point that is on all three planes, and therefore this is the point that represents our solution. If we rotate this, we can see it from a different angle. Here it is from this angle, and here's our solution from this angle. So I think it's important to keep in mind that we're actually finding a point in space when solving a system of three equations with three unknowns. I hope you found this helpful.